Hello everyone, welcome back to Learn for Tarakki. In this tutorial, we are going to learn how we can deploy Flutter web app on internet via Google Cloud Cloud Storage Service and Cloud DNS. It is a cost-effective manner to deploy Flutter web app on the internet. Here we are not using any Google Cloud load balancing service, which normally incur cost. This is beneficial for those who are looking to deploy their Flutter web application over the internet and do not want to pay much of the cost, much of the bill on top of cloud load balancer, or any startup who are done with the development and want to make a pitch. So they can simply deploy their Flutter web app in this manner and can showcase to their stakeholders. So let's get started over the architecture, and we'll learn about what all components are necessary, and we will create it over the Google Cloud. And the prerequisite for this tutorial is that you should have Flutter setup on your desktop, on your machine, Flutter web app setup on your machine, and you should have domain. You should buy a domain from domain registrar, example GoDaddy, any other domain registrar. That's the two prerequisite we have. Otherwise, rest I'm going to cover in this tutorial. So let's get started. So let me walk you to the architecture that we are going to create and that we are going to follow. Okay. So if you look into this architecture diagram, I have shown here that we have a Google Cloud. As you have Google Cloud account, so what we are going to do, we are going to first generate the Flutter app, just a sample app. In your case, your Flutter app might be ready for deployment. So we are going to generate the Flutter web app and change the title or homepage, some title, and then publish, basically build the Flutter web app in the local. And then we will create cloud storage bucket in the Google Cloud. And manually you can drag and drop the build files into the Google Cloud Storage, or you can do it via CI/CD pipeline. Those who are familiar with CI/CD, they can do that manner as well. To keep it simple, we are going to drag and drop those files into the storage bucket. So before creating the bucket, we will first do some domain related stuff. So first we are going to create a hosted zone within the Google Cloud, and that hosted zone, the domain name servers of that hosted zone should be configured into your domain registrar. Everything I'm going to show in this tutorial, I have a domain cloudkaksha.in in GoDaddy with nothing set up, nothing configured. So I'm going to do it from scratch and then create a hosted zone. The name server will be saved in the GoDaddy account, and it is ready. And then I'm going to create a bucket name with www.codekaksha.in. It is necessary to expose the cloud bucket, cloud storage bucket, with the help of Cloud DNS. And here I have shown Cloud Run. Basically, your web application might be talking to your backend system, and backend system, you can simply run it within the Cloud Run. Again, it is a cost-effective service. So your web app can make an API call into the Cloud Run. So the backend you can deploy, you can create it in any of the technology, maybe Java, Python, .NET, anything. But since we are going to consume the API directly with the Cloud Run domain name, so in that case, you should configure the cores within the backend service. Okay, you have to allow the codekaksha.in domain name into the backend service. Okay, so this is I'm going to create. Let's get started. I'm going to go to the VS Code and generate the Flutter web app. So let us see that Flutter web app, how we are going to generate. So I have this sample folder created. This folder is totally empty, and I have the Flutter setup with me. So I'm going to show you the version of Flutter I'm using. So it doesn't matter for this exercise to complete. Okay, so I'm sitting in the wrong directory because before that I have done the exercise. So let me just close the terminal and open it again. Okay, now I'm sitting in the sample folder. Let us see the version. Okay, so the version of Flutter is 3.13.3. Doesn't matter for this exercise to complete. Okay, now let me clear the terminal. I have the C command as an alias, so don't worry for the clear. And then to generate the Flutter app, Flutter create my app. Okay. click enter, and it will generate a simple Flutter app. Okay. In order to run this, we have to go to the My App folder. Okay. Let me clear the terminal. I am in the My App folder. If you look into this, we have a web. Okay. And it has a sample code. So if you want to run the sample code, we can simply write Flutter run command. It will run the sample code, ask for whether you want to run it on the Linux or Chrome. So if you want to run it on the Chrome, you just choose option 2 and it will open up the app browser window for the Flutter app. It will show basically the sample app output. So this is the sample app that Flutter has provided us. So let us quickly change the title and then we are good. For title change, let us go to the lib folder, main.dart file. And over here, this is the title. Suppose I'm going to create a code Kaksha website. Code Kaksha. Okay, I have changed the title. Save it. Title is saved. You can reload this. Okay, let me just restart it because I did not run this in the watch mode. Otherwise, it will. So again, so just to demonstrate, in your case, you have the Flutter app already running. Those who are beginner in Flutter, those who want to see it from the scratch, I'm showing it for those people. Yeah. So you look at this, the title is updated. Now we can close this up. We are done with this. Okay, clear this window. Now I'm going to generate the build for the Flutter. Flutter build command, Flutter build web, press enter. Okay, now the build is ready in the build folder. Okay, now look at this build folder. We have a web folder within the build folder, and this is the content I'm going to drag and drop into the cloud storage bucket. Okay, so let's get onto the Google Cloud account. Okay. So I have with me the Google Cloud account here. So before actually creating the bucket in this exercise, I'm going to create the Cloud DNS hosted zone. So before creating the hosted zone, let me show you. I have a domain name codekaksha.in, and nothing has been touched upon in this GoDaddy account, and it is fresh purchase. You can also purchase it from any other domain registrar. Nothing specific to GoDaddy. The settings will be similar. Okay, so what we are going to do, we are going to create a hosted zone within the Google Cloud for this exercise. Create zone, click on create zone. Zone name is any unique identifier, you can give any name. So I'm saying code Kaksha KK zone. Okay, so and then we have a DNS name. So DNS name is important here, just exact name that you have purchased. So the DNS name is code Kaksha. codekaksha.in. Okay, and then we just click on this create. Okay, now the DNS zone is created. After that, you have to add the record, add standard. Okay, now click put in as www, which is the subdomain I am adding. Okay, now I'm going to create a cname record, and here I'm going to put in the canonical name, which is this exact thing you have to write. No need to change anything. Don't worry that there is no bucket name reference here or name is mentioned, just the canonical name which Google actually says about. So everything remains the same. Cname record with www, click on create button, it will create the cname record. So cname record is ready. Make sure that you create the cname record before creating the bucket, otherwise you won't be able to follow or you won't be able to complete this exercise. Yeah, here these are the name servers. You just have to copy these name servers individually. Go to the domain registrar, click on the name servers and change name servers and choose the, I will use my own servers, and copy all the 4 name servers. This step is important. Oh, sorry, I need to save all 4. maybe this last dot is not required. Save it. So we are done with editing of the name servers in the GoDaddy. Okay. Now it will reflect quickly here. Now it will reflect quickly like this. Okay. Now I'm done with the update here. Now we can go to the cloud storage. So we are going to cloud storage service to create the bucket. So let us create the bucket again. Now let us create the cloud storage bucket again. Put in the domain name. Now as soon as we put in the domain name, we have to verify the domain. Okay. So we have to click on this link, learn more. Okay. And over here, if you go little down, click on this open search console. Okay. And here it will try to verify the domain, whether you are the real owner of the domain or not. For that, you have to type in the domain name. Code Raksha.in. Okay. Click on continue. It will check whether you are owning it or not. Okay. For that, you have to create a TXT record in the hosted zone. Now it says that TXT record you have to create, and this is the value of the TXT record. So go to the DNS again. DNS. Click on open in new tab. Go to the zone. Click on add standard. Here we have to add a TXT record. The value of the TXT record is this. Click on create. Okay. Now we have added a TXT record. Now go back to the tab, this one, and then click on verify. Now ownership is verified. Done. Okay. So this way we have validated, verified the domain name. Now you are ready to go and create the bucket. Click on create. Code Raksha.in. Make sure that you are typing in www, that is the subdomain with it. Okay. On which we are going to host our website. Or Flutter web app. Put it regional. You can also do it global. There is no hard and fast rule. Make sure that you are making this bucket as public. Click on continue. Click on create. Now this time it will create the bucket because we have proved the domain ownership. Okay. Now we just have to upload the files here, like the build files here directly. Simply go to the Explorer and then drag it from there. Now all the files are getting uploaded into the cloud storage bucket. Okay, so the upload is complete. Now go to the configuration, which is go to the permission, and this is here we are going to add the role. Click on grant access. In the principles, add all users or a small all users. Add the role. The role is cloud storage object viewer. Okay, so make sure that you are adding this all users and storage object viewer. Click on save. Allow public access. This way your bucket is completely public and exposed via cloud DNS. Okay, now we are done with this entry. Now I hope we can see the output into the domain name. Now what is the domain name that we have to use? You can type in the domain name. Okay. Can clear this out. http://www.coderaksha.in. Oh, one setting I forget to mention here. When you see this error, or those who are new to this, so why this error normally comes, there is one more setting that we have to do. Go to the bucket listing. In the listing where it says www.coderaksha.in, and make sure that you click on this menu, triple dot, and go to edit website configuration. Here you have to type in index.html, okay, and click save. Now you are ready. Let us try to see it again. I hope it should work now. Okay, my Flutter web app is now on Google Cloud, now on internet with this http://www.codekaksha.in. Okay, so this way we are done with the exercise. We have published our Flutter web app on the internet with the just two service, Cloud DNS and Cloud Storage. Once you are done with this, you can simply go to the production environment where you need to just simply switch. Instead of using the HTTP, we can use HTTPS. For that, we have to use the Cloud Load Balancer, Global Cloud Load Balancer, which is External Application Load Balancer. And then we can use the Cloud DNS, okay, along with Cloud CDN to cache the web application. So those practices we can do. In the upcoming video, I'm going to take you to that journey as well. I hope you understand the concept very well. So please like it, share it, and subscribe to our channel. Thank you so much for watching.